Good afternoon, YouTube. So this is the MT50 remote display that's on my EpEver 20 amp tracer charge controller. And I've had a number of requests from viewers to do an overview of how I have this set up. I've made a series of videos over the last few years showing particular details, but people want to see an all-in-one summary. So right here you can see I've got the solar coming in. There's not much power coming in. The sun's just going over the house. And as far as solar panels, I have two 60-watt 12-volt panels in series and two 15-watt 12-volt panels in series. So that's about 150 watts total. Open circuit voltage will get up to 43 volts, I think. And then about 3.5 amps short circuit current on there. And I've got my DC load here, and I can turn on a light. The load will go up to about 0.5 amp, and the OK button can be used to turn that load on and off. So there I've turned the load off, and it goes to 0 amps. I can turn it back on and it jumps up to 0.5 amp. This system has two batteries. I have my Harbor Freight jump start battery, which is 26 amp hours, AGM sealed lead acid battery. So my Harbor Freight backpack sprayer is also plugged in and has a 12 amp hour sealed lead acid battery. And if we go here, if you hit the escape key, you come into the menu. I'll just step down here to the device info. Sometimes people get confused by this screen. This is all read only, and it just tells you what this charge controller is rated at. So it's rated for up to 24 volt battery, up to 20 amp charge current, and up to 20 amp on the DC load output. Now I'm running 12 volt battery, but it still says 24. So that's where people get confused sometimes. It's like, how do I change that to 12? Well, it auto detects the voltage. And then we can come down here to number 4 is where the parameters are. So I have this set up with the user battery type. And that's important because the user battery type is the only setting that you can change the parameters on. And then here's my battery amp hours. Like I said, I've got a 26 amp hour battery, and it's in parallel with a 12 amp hour battery. When you have batteries in parallel, you add the amp hours. When you have batteries in series, you add the voltage. I'll talk about the user setting a little later here. So if we go down here, here's the temperature coefficient. I never changed that. And then you can see it's picked up the 12 volt battery. And then here, what I've done for my user battery setup is I took the sealed lead acid battery settings and I modified them slightly. I think I left the overvoltage the same, but I set the charge limit to 14.7. The PowerSonic data sheet lists 14.4 to 14.7. And then over here, I left these basically unchanged, but I'm not using those per se, especially the equalization charge. So I'll show you that in a little bit here. And then here's the boost charge. So I think I dropped that from 14.7 to 14.6. And then the float charge, the PowerSonic datasheet listed 13.5 to 13.8. So I picked 13.7, just a little under the maximum. And then these are the reconnect voltages. I left these unchanged. You can change them if you want. And then the low voltage warning and the disconnect 11.1 or 10.6 volts. You can change those if you want. And then what I did here on equalize time, this is one I changed because I don't want to equalize these batteries. I just set that to 0 minutes, so there's no equalization. So if you do that, it doesn't matter what you set the equalize voltage to because it'll never run. And then I maxed out the boost time up to 120 minutes. And then you're back to the beginning. So anyway, let's go back up here. That was the control parameters. Load set, I just have it set to, I believe, just manual control. So that way the OK button turns it on and off. So anyway, there's that. Device parameters, that's just where your serial number is. I set the ID on this one to 2. I've got 2 of these displays. I've got 1, and then this is 002. So if I ever were to connect these on a network, this would show up as controller number 002, and the other one would show up as 001. You can change the backlight up to 120 seconds, and then you can also set the time and date there. So that's where you do that. I have a video on that. And then there's where you change the device password. And like I said, if you're going to change it, you better remember it and write it down multiple places. And if you change the password and then you forget what it is, this unit is, it's not bricked, but you can't change anything ever again. You're stuck with the settings. So yeah, you got to be careful with that device password. But if you're going to change it, you better remember what you changed it to. And then you can look at your failure. That's an error log. I don't have anything in there. Nothing there. And then meter parameters. I think that's just the software version and whatnot. And okay, and you're back there. So anyway, that's all the settings in there. Like I said, I just took the sealed lead acid settings and then copied those into the user setting. And then I changed the boost and float voltages basically, and then turned off the equalization charge. So anyway, that's all the settings in there. So hopefully this video helps you understand all the various parameters in there, see it all at once. So yeah, that's basically an overview of how I have the MT50 display and the charge controller set up. So this should be very applicable to most of the EpEver BN series charge controllers, or any of them that have the user battery mode. So you need the user battery mode to be able to change things. If you're using sealed, flooded, or gel, all those settings are basically read-only. Yeah, hopefully that helps go through all the settings all in one video. So I'll put card links to all the detailed videos where I showed the particular settings that I did a little more detail if you want to see those. Anyway, if you have any other questions about that, post up in the comments section below. Give the video a thumbs up if you found it helpful. And as always, thanks for watching.